You've written a little bit on LinkedIn, on the media platform about the politics of anger. Can you share your thoughts on that?
It's very much related to what you were just commenting on, mm-hmm. which is taking care of the people who are being displaced, taking care of the less fortunate, taking care of the disenfranchised. Because once somebody becomes disenfranchised, once they feel like they no longer have a voice, they're not being heard, that's when bad things start to happen, when people feel like there's nothing to lose. And you're seeing it. You're not just seeing it in the United States. You're seeing it in Europe. You're seeing it all over the world right now. People are angry. There are large swaths of the population within particular countries, cities, et cetera, where people no longer feel like they have access to opportunity. They don't feel like things are fair. And even for those, there was a recent survey that just came out, recent data that was looking into why certain folks are supporting Trump here in the US presidential election. And many people had hypothesized it was folks that were out of jobs. And it turned out in certain cities, those people had jobs. They were worried about their children. Mm-hmm. And they were worried about their children's children. And they were worried about opportunities in the future. So people need to feel like they have access to opportunity. People need to feel like they have some say in these outcomes. And increasingly, you can see it with this anger. People don't feel like that. And what's happening, very unfortunately, is this wicked, vicious cycle where people are condemning, criticizing this anger. And they're saying people are voting from a place of emotion and not necessarily a place of logic or reason. And you saw it with the Brexit vote. That was a canonical example of this, where a lot of people, rather than dig in and roll up their sleeves and understand why people voted to leave and why people felt like they didn't have a voice and they were disenfranchised. Do you remember one of the most popular memes that was circulating after that vote with a number of people that had gone on to Google to ask about what Brexit was that had voted? And everyone seemed to get a big kick out of this. And there was a lot of snark that was being circulated. And there were very, very few people who were actually sitting down with the folks that had voted to leave to understand why, and to understand what misconceptions they may have had, to understand where their anger was coming from. And unfortunately, you see something very similar happening in this country right now with regard to supporters of either Hillary or Donald Trump, where there's a lot of snark flying back and forth. And by snark, I'm not even talking about the voters. I'm talking about people of influence who are commenting and observing all of this stuff. And if we took just a fraction of the snark and a fraction of the contempt, which, by the way, is inflaming the people who are angry to begin with, and invested that in understanding why people are so angry and what we can do about it, hopefully we get away from attacking the people and we start attacking the problem.